everyone, it's Rachel and welcome to my channel, and today's video is going to be another pregnancy update. I am now 35 weeks pregnant, which means I've only got 5 more weeks to go before I get to meet my baby, and I can definitely tell my body is starting to get ready for labor. So my baby is now about the size of a honeydew melon and weighs about 5.5 pounds and is 18 inches long. Their liver and their kidneys are fully developed and their lungs are just finishing getting all ready to come out into the world and breathe oxygen for the first time. I had a doctor's appointment last week. Everything looks like it's still going really well. I'm still growing properly. The baby's heart rate is still good and everything looks totally fine. My doctor talked with me a bit about C-sections at this appointment, basically just telling me reasons why I might have a C-section and the kind of incision they would do, things like that. She told me the reasons I could end up having a C-section is if the baby is not doing well with the labor, call it fetal distress, then for that reason I would have to have a C-section. If the baby is breech, so if the legs are down instead of the head, my doctor at the last appointment told me my baby was head down, so I'm hoping that breech baby won't be a problem for me. It does feel like the baby is head down as well, just with how I feel it, so I'm not really too worried about that. And then the last reason she said I could need a C-section is if the labor is just going on for hours and hours and hours and I'm just really tired, and then they'd have to do a C-section before me or the baby gets sick. It was nice to just have her explain it to me a bit so I could be more aware of what the chances were of me having a C-section and why I would need one and just some of the things that would go into it. She said my husband can still be there with me. They will probably do a bikini incision. So it was nice to just talk with her about that a little bit and be informed on that. I also went over my birth plan with them this time. Originally they told me to bring my birth plan in at 37 weeks, but then at the previous appointment, they told me that the 37 week appointment, there was going to be a bunch of tests and stuff they were going to do, and so that appointment might run longer. So to just bring it in on my 35 week appointment, which I did, I went over it with the doctor and they said it looks great and everything on my list they should be able to do. So I was really happy to hear that and know that I can hopefully follow my plan. I'm also going in for appointments a little more regularly. I was before going in every 8 weeks. And then I was doing every 3 weeks, and now it looks like I'll probably be doing every 2 weeks, well, which is only one or two more appointments before the baby is born. So a little bit more regular with appointments than before, but that's nice because I get to check up on the baby a little bit more and make sure everything is going well. So far, I have been doing a lot to get ready for this baby. I've gone and washed all the baby's clothes, all the bedding, the swaddles, all the fabric stuff the baby will be using, making sure that's all clean and ready to go. The nursery is pretty much organized and everything is set up, though the baby will be in our room for the first couple months, but I wanted to have all of that ready to go anyways. Even though the baby will not be sleeping in there, I will still be using it for diaper changes and for playtime and stuff like that for nursing. So I still wanted to have that room kind of set up and ready to go anyways. There's still a couple more things that need to be organized, but that room is pretty much ready to go, which is really nice. Got that out of the way. I've also been doing a bunch of meal prepping, getting some freezer meals ready to go for when the baby comes so I don't have to do a lot of cooking, because I know I won't feel like it, and my husband Elias is probably not going to feel like it a lot either. We're both going to be pretty tired and busy, so I wanted to have a couple meals in the freezer ready to go. We did end up finding a freezer. We bought it a couple weeks ago, so that's been so nice, having the extra space for us to be able to put stuff in. And for me to be able to have somewhere to store our meals in our house. I was originally planning to store them at my parents' place. They don't live very far, but it's definitely nicer just having it in the house. So whenever we're hungry, we can just go ahead, grab it out of the freezer and eat. I also packed up our hospital bags throughout the week, just kind of slowly putting stuff together. Went online and looked up a whole bunch of different lists to get an idea of what I should put in my hospital bag. That is all done, ready to go. They're sitting by the door, and just nice to kind of get that off my list of to-dos and not have to worry about it. I have been reading a lot of articles on getting ready for labor, on like tips for managing pain, how to make labor easier, different ways I can just be prepared, and also how to avoid tearing, because that is one of my biggest fears with my labor, is that I'm going to tear. I am really hoping I don't, but I know it is quite common. but I've been trying to find some tips and tricks on how to avoid tearing as much as possible so I can not worry about it so much. My husband and I also watched an online prenatal class, and it was really helpful. It had the before and when, like, you start going into labor, so the early stages of labor to a month to a few weeks before labor, and then the actual whole laboring, pushing, delivering process, and then postpartum recovery and also taking care of a baby. It was really helpful. We really enjoyed it. We both learned a lot from it and feeling a little bit more calm and prepared now that we both have a better idea of what to expect. This was a class I watched earlier in my pregnancy, in like the first trimester, but that was quite a few months ago, so it was nice to have a bit of refresher and watch it again and just be reminded of some things. So yeah, we are pretty much ready to go for this baby. We're both really excited and looking forward to meeting them for the first time, looking forward to feeling a bit more normal. I have been having a little bit more soreness and tightness lately, especially in my hips. I've had the past couple days a little bit of what I think is sciatica. I'm not exactly sure, but it's just been like kind of like numb tingling in like my left foot and leg, and sometimes it kind of like I get this shooting nerve pain down my leg. I don't know, it's kind of weird. Hasn't bothered me a whole lot. I think there was one night where it lasted for half an hour before I went to bed, and then I woke up and it was fine. But other than that, I'm doing pretty well. My back has been a little bit more sore lately with all the weight. It really hasn't been that bad, and it's just started to bother me more recently. And I only have 5 weeks left to go, so I'm really grateful that it hasn't been a huge problem for me. So I'm going to show you guys a belly shot now, show you how I'm looking at 35 weeks with only 5 weeks left to go. The baby has been sitting pretty low lately. Definitely there's a lot more pressure down there. The baby spends a lot more time down there now as we're getting closer to the due date. So that also adds to why I've been having more lower back pain. Still have not been noticing any stretch marks, so I can definitely feel my belly growing. I've been feeling a lot of stretching lately. So far, I'm growing really well. Everything seems to be going great. So thank you guys for watching today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it, and if you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you want to follow along for the last few weeks of my pregnancy journey, then be sure to subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.